Hey folks, Roby here with another Divi tutorial brought to you by the Divi Engine team. In this tutorial series, we're going to be showing you how to undivify your Divi sites by fixing those dead giveaways that show that your site was built with Divi. Now today, we're going to be showing you two approaches to fixing the default button styles in Divi, so let's jump right to it. Now, looking at my screen here, you can see the dead giveaway Divi button styles. It's this blue outline with the icon on hover. And as well, you can see that it goes from the button module over to the contact form, and it just isn't very appetizing to the eye. Now, there's obviously a lot of stuff on this page that is a dead giveaway that this is a Divi site. You look at the menu bar up here, it's just a standard menu bar. And then, of course, the footer is another giveaway. So definitely follow along with the series if you want to see how to fix all of these different elements in Divi to make your sites that are built with Divi not look like Divi sites. But now we're going to take two approaches here to fixing the buttons. We are first going to look at setting a global style, and then we're going to look at the global presets, where you might have one or two different button styles that you'd like to use on your site. And I'm going to show you a very easy way to go through and select those as you go through. So let's go. Okay, so now to set those button styles at a global level so that all your buttons start out with a predefined style, you can do it one of two ways or access it one of two ways. You go to the theme customizer. Now, one way is to come up here and then just clicking on theme customizer, and that'll load on up. And you'll see that left-hand bar. Now, I know in the future this is going to go away because Divi is just going to internalizing a lot of the options, but for now, this is the way we do this. Now, the other way you can access the theme customizer, of course, is on the dashboard here by going to Divi. You can click on theme customizer here, and then there's even one more spot in appearance, and you can click on customize. That'll all take you to the same spot. Now, here on the front end, we have a few options, but one of them is buttons. So let's go over there. We'll go to button style. Now you can go ahead, and I'm not going to make the most beautiful button here, but you'll get the idea of how to go about working with these. So for background color, I can just come in and we'll select some greenish color. Let's see. It's kind of close to the Divi Engine green. And then I'll just drive this slider all the way up. For some reason, it starts with zero opacity, so you're going to want to drag that all the way up. Now we see that immediately these buttons change style on the page. Maybe we'll give them white text. And for border width, I'm going to take that all the way down. And border color, I don't need to touch now. And maybe we'll give it a border radius of 5. And now we can see the button's already looking a little bit more uniform, a little bit less Divi-like. For me, I don't like that arrow, so I'm going to use this one. For the hover, that looks better for me. And then also you can change the button font. So I'm going to go down all the way to Poppins. Now I wish they would make a searchable list here for the fonts as they do within the Divi Builder, but this is of course part of WordPress. So no luck there. So I changed that to Poppins. I'm going to make that button font style nice and bold, and that's a good starting point. Now, as I said, you can see here that it goes from just the button module all the way to the form module. That default button style is set, and that is the first way to go ahead and change that default Divi button style. Now, I'll just go ahead and publish this to commit my changes, and then we'll go to the front end and click the X there, and you can see that the styles have been committed. Now we can go ahead and change the hover style. You see that the hover style was not affected. So we just go again up here and we say customize or theme customizer. Go back to button, and here are the hover styles. Now we don't want to change the text color. We also just want the background color to remain the same. So all we do is bring that up all the way. That makes it all white. So maybe on hover, we'll just go back to the green. It changes the green a bit, but you can kind of see how you can go about adding different elements here. Maybe on hover, you want to add a little bit of letter spacing. See how that kind of works out there. Now, this is not the prettiest looking button ever. But you kind of get the idea of different things that you can do here as far as setting a global button style. That's going to be your start off point for, you know, fully customizing these. So next up, we're going to look at setting individual button styles, and maybe that would be for different use case buttons. Maybe one's for a contact form, maybe another one is for, you know, skipping to a section or linking to a product, something like that. So let's look at that next. Okay, so to get rolling here with our global button presets, I'm going to go ahead and edit this page. There we go. And let's see if we get the famous Divi double load. We did not. Lucky us. Okay, so let's go into visual mode here. So we like to see what we're doing as we're doing it. As we can see, these are individual button modules, and then this is a form. We're not going to be touching this one. This one was more to demonstrate that those global button styles do go across modules. These ones are going to be module specific. So let me go into the button settings here. And now up here, you'll notice the preset, and it's set to default. Now, you can go in here and edit the default settings for our button modules here. So you go to design, and maybe you want all your buttons default preset to be center, and you see how all the button modules get adjusted as I go through this. Now, I kind of like my buttons in the middle normally, so if I use a button module, I'm going to say yes, I do want it to be centered. Maybe what I also would like is for my buttons to have a shadow. That looks good. And but you notice here that this form button is not affected. That is because this is module specific, these presets. So that is important to keep in mind. This is just, of course, the other way that you can create some presets. So let's look at the rest of that. I think that's okay. So this will be our default preset. Now, see, this will affect all button modules across the site. Do I wish to proceed? Yes, I do. And then I can just check that box, and now we're good to go. And we have that default preset. Now, any button, and let me show you here. If I add another button module to my page here, you see that it loads in with those defaults that I had set. That is why this is such a powerful tool and lets you define your style for your buttons and then carry it over to different areas of your site, and it just makes you more efficient. So I'll go ahead and delete that button. And then what I'm going to do is let's define another preset. So we'll come up here, and here you can select create new preset from current styles. That would give you, you know, using these presets to go and define it maybe a little bit further. That's a good idea to kind of keep a similar aesthetic. So let me say yes. And now I'm going to say product button. I don't know. That could be whatever. We're not going to assign this as a default. So let's check that. And now we've got the product button style. So let's go to design here. And for product buttons, let's say I want custom styles for the button, of course. And then we will make the background. Let's give the background a gradient here. Let's make it a little interesting. Let's keep it linear. We'll give it like a nice angle there. That looks good. And we're not going to repeat the gradient. But now you can already see that this button is by itself looking different than the other ones already. For this one, we will give it a nice bold font, ultra bold. And then maybe we'll select a cool icon here. Let's see product. Let's see if there's anything in there. Oops. Product. Okay, so maybe we'll put this shopping cart icon on there. And then, of course, you can do a lot of different other things. You can go ahead with the spacing, maybe. Let's come down here, spacing. Let's add padding top and bottom of 5. Well, that didn't do much. 15. There we go. Now we've got a bigger button. It's going to stand out a little bit more on the page. And let's save that and say yes. And save that. Now, let's say I'm on a page, I just added a button module, and let's emulate that. Let's go add a button module. Now I can just go up here and say, oh, well, this is going to be a product button. I click that, and boom, I've got a product button on the page. It's a very helpful tool to just create some uniformity along your sites and eliminate that infamous Divi button style that gets added by default's dead giveaway. Now, that is what we're going to cover as far as button styles go here. I hope you guys found this helpful. Definitely follow along with the entire series because we are going to be eliminating a lot of those pitfalls with Divi sites that let you know that, oh, this is a Divi site. You want to create a little bit more of a bespoke series, and that's what we're here for right now with this tutorial series on undivifying your Divi websites. Guys, this was Roby with the Divi Engine team. Definitely like and subscribe as to not miss any of the installments in this series. I thank you for your time, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye for now.